and welcome to Edu Club for you again. And we move forward to the next video related to time and work. And in this video, we try to find out what are the technical process in which we can find out the answer of a complex question instantly. I'll give you different process that this is the process where you can find out in 10 seconds. This is the process you can find out in 20 seconds. So we'll discuss everything part by part and how the efficiency of a person can be utilized in a question. But before we move forward to this video, I again request all of you to kindly subscribe this channel. Whatever the data, whatever the query that you have, you write down in this page. Like our videos, share our videos. Okay, thank you. So, let us start this video with the question. Let's suppose A is 20% less efficient than B. Okay, now, if B is needed 24 days to finish the job alone, find how much time or how much days required by A and B together to finish the job. This is the question. Now, according to this question, it is given that A is 20% less efficient than B. So we can take here that if B consume 100 laddus, then A can consume 80. Okay. And we know that efficiency is what? It is just reverse of time. If somebody is more efficient, then he is needing less time period. Okay. So, if B consume 100 laddus and A 80 number of laddus, if you consider the time for the same work, then if A will take 100 days, the same work can be finished by B in 80 number of days. Take the ratio. The ratio is what? 5:4. If A will take 5 days, then B will take 4 days. But in this question, it is given that B is required 24 days. So 4 pertaining to 24. So for 5 pertaining to what? Here into 6. So here also into 6. 5 into 6, 30 days. Now, A is needing 30 days. B is 24 days. So together they can finish the job in how many days? 30 into 24 divided by 30 plus 24. The result is what? 13/3. Okay. But we can go through some other process also. Okay. So try to find out the logic here. As per the question is concerned, A can consume 80 laddus where B can consume 100. Question is together. So together they can consume how many laddus? 80 plus 100, A plus B means 180 laddus. Okay, now it is given that B takes 24 days to finish the job. Okay, as I am saying that efficiency is reverse to time. Okay, now the time A plus B can consume 180. B is consuming 100. B need how much? 24 days. So total number of laddus is what? 2400. Consumed by A and B. So 2400 divided by 180. Finished. 13/3. There is no need to find out what is the time required by A alone. Because in this question it is given together. Together is what? 180. If B consume 100 laddus per day, in 24 days, total we are having 2400. Now, this 2400 laddus consumed by A and B divided by 180. finished. Okay, now let us discuss some other question. Okay, let us suppose it is given in the question that B is twice efficient than A. B is twice efficient than A. Now, A alone can finish the job in 15 days. A started the work, B joined after some days, and after 11 days, the work finished. The question is, find after how many days B joined A. Let us find out. B is twice efficient than A. What does this mean? If A will consume one laddu, B can consume two number of laddus. It is given in the question, A alone need 15 days to finish the job. So within 15 days, if A is consuming one laddu per day, means total we are having 15 laddus. Okay? Now, A is work from the beginning till the end, total 11 days. B join after some days. So within that 11 days, A can finish how many laddus? 1 into 11, 11 laddus finished by A. Now, remaining is what? Total we are having 15, A consumed 11, so remaining is 4. What is the capability of B? 2 laddus per day. So 4 divided by 2 means B is needing only 2 days. So if B is working for 2 days, total we are having 11 days. So 11 minus 2, 9 days. After 9 days, P join. Okay, you can find out mentally if you are having little bit of concentration. There is no need of pen and paper. You can find out mentally. Okay, I'll give you some different question here. Let's suppose there is a joint venture of two different type of people. Some men are working with some women, or some men are working with some boys. A variety of questions are there related to time and work. So let us consider an example. Three men with four women working together can finish a piece of work in 12 days. Okay? Now, the same work, five men with eight women working together can finish the same piece of work in 7 days. Now the question is, how many men along with 12 women can finish the piece of work in 4 days? This is the question that we have. So when two different people combinedly they work, we have to find out the work ratio or days ratio or efficiency ratio, whatever. We need the ratio. Man is to a man. Okay? Now, so write down the equation by simply using both the datas we have. The first data is 3 man plus 4 man in 12 days. This is the same work done by 5 men and 8 women in 7 days. Okay. So, here if you multiply, you will get what? 3 into 12 means 36 men plus 48 women. This is equivalent to 35 men with 7 into 8, 56 women. It means we are having one man equals to eight women. Okay. Now, we can utilize this ratio in any one of the data that you have. The beginning data, what we have? 3 men with 4 women. But we know that 1 man equals to 8 women. So 3 men equals to 3 into 8, 24 women. So 24 women plus 4 women means 28 women can finish the job in 12 days. How many women can finish it in 4 days? If you cut 4, then here what we have? Total, let us suppose this is 7, this is 12. 12 into 7, 84 days. 84 women is required. 84 women can finish this work in 4 days. But already we are having 12 women. So how much extra women needed? 72. 1 man equals to 8 women. So 72 women is equivalent to 72 divided by 8. 9 men. Finished. So every time when two different variety of people is given, men, women, men, boys, you simply find out the ratio and convert all in either man or in woman to get the result. Okay? Let us try another question. So let us try this question where the working ratio is given, or the time ratio is given. I'll give you that question. The ratio of the days taken by A and B is 2:3. And the ratio of days taken by B and C is 4:7. Okay, this is part one. The second is, A takes 26 days less in comparison to C. ABC start the work, and after 3 days, B leave. The question is, how much time required to finish the job? Okay, now, we can apply the ratio here. A:B 2:3. Now B:C 4:7. So by utilizing both the ratio, we can find out A:B:C as 8:12:21. Means if A is needing 8 days, then B takes 12 days, C takes 21 days to complete the job. But in this question, it is given that A is taking 26 days less. But here in this ratio, the difference between 21 and 8, 13, 21 minus 8. But in this question, it is given as 26 days. So double of that. Okay, so this, with the same ratio, we can write down that if A is taking 16 days, then B will take 24 days and she will take 42 days. So there is a gap of 26 days in between A and C. Now, all start together and after 3 days, B leave the job. So we go through the same process, take the LCM of the three, 16, 24 and 42. So LCM is what? 336, let us. So A can consume per day 336 divide 16, 21 let us per day. B will consume 336 divided by 24, 14 let us per day. C will consume 336 divided by 42, 8 laddus per day. Okay, now B left after 3 days. What is the capability of B here? The capability of B is 14 laddus per day. So within 3 days, B will consume 14 into 3, 42 number of laddus. And the remaining consumed by A and C. So what is the remaining? Total we are having 336 minus 42. 294 laddus consumed by A and C. Now, A having capacity of 21, C having capacity of 8. So 21 plus 8 means 29 laddus per day. The total we are having left is 294. 294 divided by 29. 29 tens are 290. So this is 10, 4 by 29 days. Finished. So every time if you consider the efficiency in time and work, we can find out everything in a very fast manner. We'll discuss some questions related to pipe and system. This is just the same as time and work in the next video. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.